The U.S. expands sanctions against Russia, this time targeting the company in charge of building Russia's Nord Stream 2 gas pipeline. Under the directive of President Joe Biden, the U.S. Treasury Department issued a general license authorizing the wind down of transactions with Nord Stream 2 AG until March 2. The move comes a day after Germany halted the $11 billion project in response to Russia's recognition of the two breakaway regions.
Ukraine now under a state of emergency amid a potential Russian invasion. Ukraine's state border guards have tightened security regions or in regions bordering Russia and Belarus. The foreign ministry also urging Ukrainian citizens to leave Russia. Meanwhile, shelling intensified in eastern Ukraine, where Russian President Vladimir Putin recognized the independence of two Moscow-backed rebel regions. Speaking before the UN General Assembly, Ukraine appealed for help from the global body.
Active diplomacy, strong political messaging, tough economic sanctions, and strengthening Ukraine can still force Moscow to abandon aggressive plans. Swift and resolute actions by the United Nations can reclaim the organization's leading role at this historic and dark moment.
Russia continues to deny it is planning an invasion, calling the accusations at a Russian hysteria. But it has made no move to withdraw its troops along Ukraine's front lines.
Ukraine also allegedly under cyber attack. State websites, which have experienced outages in recent weeks, were again offline on Wednesday. The Minister of Digital Transformation also says several banks were affected. According to cybersecurity firm ESET, a newly discovered piece of destructive software found circulating in Ukraine has hit hundreds of computers. Russia has repeatedly denied any hand in the cyber attacks.
European Union leaders will hold an emergency summit on Thursday to decide on further actions against Russia. The Eurobloc says it is ready to launch a second package of sanctions against Moscow if Russian troops move beyond the Ukrainian regions held by Russian-backed separatists.
Coming with a strong sanctions against Russia and taking into account Russia's possible reactions, it is going to have some impact on the EU economy, and we need to be ready for this. But the question is that here we have the sovereignty and territorial integrity of Ukraine at stake. We have broader EU security architecture at stake, so we need to be able to react and also take some economic cost if it's necessary.
The first round of sanctions took effect on Wednesday. It included blacklisting more politicians and curbing trade between the EU and two breakaway regions. The sanctions sent energy prices surging and financial markets tumbling.